Hi everyone, welcome back to Alice and the Giant Bookshelf. Today's video is a book mail unboxing, but I've got something a bit different to unbox. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. My name's Alice and I have way too many books, and in spite of that I have received some book mail today, and I'll tell you a little bit about it. So the other day I received my book mail from Mr. B's, which is my usual unboxing that I do once a month. I receive a crime syndicate subscription from Mr. B's Emporium in Bath. They send one crime fiction book every month, and I did unbox that on camera for you, as I always do, but unfortunately my microphone decided it was going to give up the ghost and make loud sounds, so the audio wasn't usable. So I'm going to insert a clip here where I will be in different clothes and unboxing a book but with no sound. So here's me unboxing my book. As you can see, it was yet another new author to me and another book that I had never heard of, which is great. You can see here I am taking off the dust jacket that it always comes in and having a look at the book for the very first time. So that book that came out of the box was On Java Road by Lawrence Osborne, and this is a book set in Hong Kong, and it says on the back, after 20 years as an expat reporter in Hong Kong, Adrian Guile has almost nothing to show for it. But now the streets are choked with students demanding democratic freedoms and the old world is beginning to fall apart. Adrian's old friend Jimmy Tang, the scion of a wealthy Hong Kong family, has begun a reckless affair with Rebecca, a leading pro-democracy protester. But when Rebecca disappears and Jimmy goes to ground, Adrian unearths the familiar old urge to investigate. Pursuing Rebecca's ghost to Java Road, where the city's dead congregate, Adrian reassembles her final hours as he struggles to distinguish between delusion and reality. And the Sunday Times described this as superbly atmospheric, his most compulsive yet. The Guardian described it as an atmospheric portrait both of a particular place and time and of the creation and destruction of a friendship. Highly recommended. So this was first published last year and it was published in paperback in 2023, and yeah, it's a very short book, 200 and something pages, and I've not heard of Lawrence Osborne before, but it does say he's the author of critically acclaimed novels The Forgiven, The Ballad of the Small Player, Hunters in the Dark, Beautiful Animals, and Only to Sleep, which is a Philip Marlowe novel commissioned by the Raymond Chandler Estate, and The Glass Kingdom. He's also written some non-fiction, and it says here that his other book, The Forgiven, has been released as a film in 2022, starring Ralph Fiennes, Matt Smith, and Jessica Chastain. And Osborne lives in Bangkok. So yeah, that was my book from Mr. B's. Hopefully I've accompanied it with a clip of me getting it out of the box. If not, sorry about that, it was because my microphone failed. So yeah, I received that from Mr. B's as normal. And this morning's been a very overexciting morning, so if I'm a bit hyped up in this video, it's because I've been watching The Lionesses Came against Haiti. And if you've watched my channel before, you will know I'm co-hosting the Women's World Cup Readathon, where we are reading books connected to the countries, and my team is Denmark. They're playing very shortly, so this won't be a very long video, because I need to watch Denmark and see if I need to read a book from China. But yes, England beat Haiti 1-0. It was far from a comfortable victory, although England did have lots of chances. I think Haiti actually looked like a really promising team, and I might have to do some further research into what book I will read if Haiti beat Denmark. So anyway, if you would like to know more about the Women's World Cup Readathon, please go and check out my announcement video, which is linked below, along with my fellow co-hosts Mark at Booktime with Elvis, Roz at Scally Dandling about the books, and Jack from Rambling Raconteur. So yeah, that's going on at the moment. Today's definitely been the most exciting day for me of the tournament so far, obviously following England, and this afternoon following the team I've been drawn from the hat, Denmark. But anyway, while I was watching the England match, a very large parcel arrived, and I have removed my address from this parcel, and I've also cut the tape on it, but I haven't yet seen what's inside. I have a little idea of what's inside because this has come from the Foundling Museum. And what happened was I entered a giveaway on Instagram, a competition from the Foundling Museum, and it was in collaboration with Kirsty Capes. Now, you may or may not know, depending how long you've been watching my channel, but Careless by Kirsty Capes was one of my top favourite books of last year. I read it for the Women's Prize. I feel it was robbed of a place on the shortlist last year, and I think it's a really, really excellent book. I do have an individual review of Careless. I will link that in the description down below. I was supposed to be filming today with some Jane Austen content, but I'm overexcited and I want to unbox this parcel, and I thought I would do it on camera. So anyway, I won this giveaway. I know that one of the things in this box is going to be some Kirsty Capes books. I believe both her books were included in this giveaway. And I also think that there are some other like memorabilia from the Foundling Museum. So very, very excited to get to this and open this. And thank you to the Foundling Museum. They haven't sponsored me or anything, but they have sent me this because I have won a giveaway on Instagram. I will link them in the description down below to their Instagram, and also, of course, the lovely Kirsty Capes. So let's get this open, if I've cut the tape properly, which I don't seem to have. So I've just got to break that last bit of tape, and I've got a big box here with some goodies in. So we will see. There's some, oh, a copy of Love Me, Love Me Not, which I'm so excited to get to. I actually had this out of the library at the time when I won the giveaway, and I hadn't got to it yet, so I decided to take it back and have a look at the lovely new, brand new copy that I had won. And this has got a lovely bookmark inside it. Sorry, just been to answer my door. So back to the parcel. Just looking at this fabulous copy of Love Me, Love Me Not. And it's got a bookmark inside, which is a Foundling Museum bookmark. It's got some information on the back about the tokens. It says that between the 1740s and 1760s, mothers leaving their babies at the Foundling Hospital would also leave a small object as a means of identification. Most tokens were everyday objects such as scraps of paper, fabric, coins, or ribbons. Some parents chose to inscribe their token with their names or the name of their child. The tokens were kept in the hospital archive, not given to the child. Most have remained unclaimed. So that's really sad. Very lovely bookmark though from the Foundling Museum. Really like that. And that was inside Love Me, Love Me Not. So that's a beautiful item. And there's also a lovely copy of Careless. I do have a copy of this. My other copy's up here. And also in here I have got a leaflet about an exhibition at the Foundling Museum about what is family. That looks really interesting, and that runs until the 27th of August by the looks of it. And also in the box I have got a mug. Looks like it's going to be a mug anyway. And that's it for the box. Let's look at this, if I can get it undone. Oh cool, this is a Foundling Museum mug. It says Foundling Museum on the bottom, and it's got all different characters. This is, I believe this is written, some of this is written on the wall in the Foundling Museum, because I've had a drink in their cafe before. And it says Princess Leia was adopted, Rapunzel was fostered, and so on. It's got lots of different people. So like Spider-Man was adopted, Superman was a foundling, Wolverine was orphaned, Tom Sawyer was adopted. All different characters from literature and from film. So that is very cool. I will enjoy having a cup of tea in that. Maybe even in a future video you will see this mug. So yeah, that's it for my unboxing, I think. So I won this lovely mug from the Foundling Museum, and these two lovely books and bookmark. They're really, really thrilled with these, and what a lovely parcel to receive. Thank you to the Foundling Museum for that, and really pleased with my Mr. B's book as well, as always. That's all for today. I've got the Denmark match to go and watch, so I'm not going to keep you any longer. If you are watching the Women's World Cup, I hope you have a really good weekend of football, and if not, have a great weekend. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, I hope you'll give it a like, and I hope you'll consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, and I'll hope very much to see you all again soon for another video all about books here on Alice and the Giant Bookshelf. Bye for now.